It's time for our tale of the tape. Introducing first, it's Katie Taylor. She's 165 centimeters tall with a reach of 160. Introducing first, it's Katie Taylor, one of the best to ever do it, fighting out of Iowa.
This bout is scheduled for 10 rounds of boxing.
All the talking has been done. It's time to start doing the walking.
You can't beat a good old-fashioned rivalry. When there's guts, when there's feeling, and when there's heart involved, that's when you get a good fight, one-on-one.
You must obey. Good luck.
And that's the opening bell, round one. They both want a highlight reel knockout. She blocks the jab. The audience absolutely right on top of you in this very special environment here.
Todd, I love theaters. For all these reasons, you can hear everybody in the crowd. You can hear the punches. The punches actually echo. If you're that fighter coming in and you know you're in such an intense atmosphere, you know the pressure is going to be on.
These two women pretty close halfway through the round. She misses with that jab. She misses with the jab. She throws the jab, but it doesn't score. Offense all the time. Which one of these athletes is going to say, I can't take it anymore? This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
Dominance, without a doubt, made look so, so easy.
And there's the bell for round two. She's coming off a fantastic last round. Let's see what she's going to do here. They both want a knockout, you can tell. Left scores. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. Good counter punch. This is a high octane battle. Someone punches that hard, you don't want to trade shots. Did well to get out of the way of that right uppercut. We get it heated back up. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
The bell rings and we start the third.
She's coming off a fantastic last round. Let's see what she's going to do here. The bravery being shown here is just incredible. Just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. She can't find a home for that jab. So that left lands. Two women pretty close halfway through the round. I think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and footwork. They're relaxed. They're confident. They know they just have to push first. Boom! In a split second, they've let four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed, and that's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
She blocks the hook. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you know who.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
To the fourth we go.
She's coming off a fantastic last round. Let's see what she's going to do here. Good punch.
Stamina is so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again and the fight will be over.
Just misses with the right uppercut. That's a scoring left hand. Nice punch. So far, the offense has been better than the defense. She just misses with that big right hand. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Well, we know they've got the advantage so far, but who's going to land the first big shot?
She's coming off a fantastic last round. Let's see what she's going to do here. correct me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
What you've got to do, Teddy, is anticipation. You've got to wait. You've just got to throw caution to the wind and just hope. You're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You've just got to put in the guess.
No stamina, no injury, but still throwing punches. Two women pretty close halfway through the round. That left hand misses. You'd like to see this fighter protect themselves a little better. Missed with that right uppercut. Uppercut just missed. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, it's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter. And the corner man's got to put a firecracker on that fighter. Get out there and get the job done.
This is the beginning of round six. Can they seal the deal in this round after what we saw just a minute ago? Would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Nice punch. Fighters landing in these exchanges. Judge is going to have a tough job. And that right jab just misses. Endurance is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're going to find out.
Final 10 seconds here, and this has not been her best round. So it's plan B time after being knocked down in that round.
I love the response, though.
There's the bell to start round 7. She got dropped in the last round. Let's see how she does here. Swing and a miss with the left uppercut. It's obvious the spider is gassed out. Why sit in there and throw punches? Oh, trying to fight her way out of this. She might just want to hold on and play some tip. Down goes Terry Harper. The corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down. Big shot sends Harper to the canvas.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
It looks like she's going to survive the round, but just barely. Well, she's been knocked down twice. Let's see how this corner handles things as they got a minute to get it together.
There's always a way back. Don't ever run anybody up.
And they're back at it again here in round 8. Two knockdowns in the last round. What do we have in store here?
Two knockdowns, and you're coming back from that. That's near on impossible, because your head must be all over the place. Your legs are feeling like jelly. What can they tell you in the corner? All they can do is wake you up. They can't even go into game plan.
Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you don't think of him. You just have to be smarter than him. You've got to be like a little fag of a pickpocket.
Right punch. Those who thought this would be a mismatch, you are sorely wrong. Solid punch. And that's the right decision here. Betcher moved to grab on, but referee might want to step in here. He's got his eyes on it. And that's exactly where she doesn't need to be. And she has no choice but to take a knee.
She definitely knows she's lost a round, Todd. So taking the knee, it means nothing. It isn't giving her any advantage or disadvantage. She's just giving herself 1 minute, 8 seconds rest.
This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. About a one-sided 3 minutes we just saw.
I seriously hope.
There's the bell to start round 9. After a really strong round, let's see if they can finish the job.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing, because you've won that hands down.
So it's onward and upward after another knockout win here.
What a shot. What a shot. You see shots like that in the gym. At least for once, this is on TV. Thousands around the world saw that shot. They probably even heard it.